2 hours later.
Have you guys ever gone fishing? Were you guys able to catch anything? You know, when I was little, I used to go fishing once in a while, and sometimes I would catch so much fish very easily, but sometimes it really took a lot of patience and perseverance just to catch one or two, or sometimes nothing at all. And in today's story, we're gonna talk about some men, professional fishermen, that stayed out all night fishing but came back with nothing. But they encounter Jesus and their whole lives are changed. So let's open our Bibles to Luke 5, 1 through 11, and Luke 6, 12 through 19. And you can pause this video and take the time to read through these passages before we watch the video.
His ministry had begun. He traveled around preaching about God and telling people to turn away from their sins. People started talking about Jesus and the things he was teaching. They were interested in what Jesus had to say. Large crowds followed Jesus around and listened to him teach. One day, Jesus was walking along the Sea of Galilee. He saw two brothers, Simon, who was called Peter, and Andrew. Peter and Andrew were fishermen. Jesus called out to them, "Follow me, and I will teach you to fish for people." Right away, Peter and Andrew dropped their nets and followed Jesus. Later, he saw two more brothers. Their names were James and John. They were in a boat, fixing nets with their father, Zebedee. Jesus called out to them, and right away they got up, left their father and the boat, and followed Jesus. Later, Jesus gathered his followers together and chose 12 of them to be his disciples. Jesus' apostles would work closely with Jesus and would go out to tell others about him. These are the men Jesus chose: Simon, who was called Peter, Simon's brother, Andrew, James and John, who were called the Sons of Thunder, Philip and Bartholomew, Matthew and Thomas, James and the son of Alphaeus, Thaddeus, Simon the Zealot, and Judas Iscariot.
Rather than waiting for his disciples to come to him, Jesus sought out his disciples and he found them doing everyday things. And when he approached these ordinary men and said, "Follow me," these men literally dropped everything and followed Jesus. And what about you? What would you do? What if Jesus came to you one day and said, "Hey, follow me"? Would you be able to give up everything and follow him? The first disciples that followed Jesus, they left everything behind, but they gained something much, much greater, and that is a personal relationship with God. Now, right now, we're gonna play a little game, and we're gonna show you first how it's played. And the second time around, I want you to see if you guys could follow along as the last person. So I am the leader in this game. Today I brought three others to play along with me. The way that we play this game is that the leader does one movement for a count of four. And when I'm done with that four count, the next person, person number two, the first movement for a count of four. Then person number three follows that first movement for a count of four. And then finally, person number four does the first movement. The key is to keep your eyes on the person right in front of you, not the main leader. Why don't you see how we do and see if anybody messes up?
Ready? One, two, three, four. One.
One, two, three, four. One,
one, two, three, four.
One, two, three, four.
One, one, two, three, four.
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 One, two, three, four. One, two, three,
four. How do we do? Why don't you guys try it with us this time? You can be person number five.
1, 2, 3, 4.
So in this game, there was one leader that set the movements for everyone to follow, but while everyone was a follower, they were also a leader because the first person leads and the second person has to follow the leader, but the third person has to watch the second person and the fourth person has to watch the third person, right? And if one of them, you know, and this could go on and on and on, on with hundreds of people actually, but if one person decides, hey, I don't feel like doing this anymore, or they just, you know, do something else, then it will affect the whole line of people that are following, right? And this is not easy to do. Wasn't it confusing? It was so hard to do even for us. Okay, now here is the real challenge. What about following Jesus? Would you do your best to follow Jesus? You know, if you already believe that Jesus died on the cross and rose again to save us, you know, then he is calling you to be his disciples. And the best way to do that is to pray and read the Bible every day so that we can get to know Jesus better, just like the disciples did by living with him every day. And also, he is calling us not only to follow Jesus, but to also share about Jesus to others. This is what Jesus was telling the disciples when he first called them, that he will make them fishers of men. That means that he will build them up so that they will be able to bring other people to Jesus. And this is what he is also calling us to do. Now, I know that this is not easy. It is not going to be easy. There's going to be things that we have to give up. We have to decide every single day and make choices to follow Jesus. But if we really believe that he is the only way, then we will also know that nothing that we give up will be more valuable than the relationship that we have with Christ. Let's come to the Lord in prayer. Dear God, we thank you so much for the love that you give to us, Lord. We thank you that you call on us to follow you, Lord, because we know that that is really the best way. That is the greatest way. You are calling us to have a personal relationship with you and to grow in that relationship, Lord. So we want to follow you, Lord God. Help us to obey you, help us to learn from your word, and help us to grow each and every day, Lord. We thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, right now we're going to have a time of offering, and again, I ask you guys to give your whole heart to God as we offer our hearts, our lives, and if you have money prepared, you know, I really want you guys to take this time to do the offering. So let's sing this song together and give our heart to God.
Turning back.
let's pray one last time as we close. Dear God, we thank you so much for all that you've done, Lord. It is because of your sacrifice that we are able to live, and as a gratitude of thanksgiving, Lord, we give you this offering, and we pray that each and every day we will be able to offer up our hearts and our lives to you. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.